In Escuban project. Wow.
Your microphone.
Oh. Excuse me. I'm visiting Escuban project, and our project contains two main applications: is Escuban illustration program and UniConverter command line tool for vector graphics translation. I think my talk will be short because I have only three news concerning our projects for you. First news, yesterday we have released our new site. It has an important milestone for our project because in our plans, our new site is the main platform for communication between our users and project developers. This one. Unfortunately, I have no connection to internet at this moment, so I'm just showing a local copy. The next issue is concerning UniConverter. Before LGM conference, we have a good news. UniConverter. Was selected as a finalist of Trophies de Libre contest. It's a real subject for pride because only Escuban project was to be nominated by this award in such contest during 5 years of the during five editions of this contest. And the last news. Is major news. We are proud to present our first stable version of SQ1. Today morning we have released our first stable version. What major feature of this version? This one. Of course, as our software is oriented for purpose, so we have support for smart colors and spot colors. It's not a new feature. Out of, for example, Inkscape and GIMP actually discussed this smart issue on this moment. For purpose application like SQ1, it was a first requirement, and therefore we have implemented this feature 2 years ago, and last issues were resolved on hub contest in the Switzerland. We have implemented smart color spaces for bitmaps. Second major feature of SQ1 is multi-document interface, which is implemented like in Firefox, that is on tabs. Another feature is a multi-document interface. So our application allows to create multi-document presentation on something else. For example, this simple presentation also created in SQ1. Of course, it's not contain something special graphics on the text, but the multi-document interface for the multi-page document is really useful. Also, application contain color management using little CMS library and carrier-based trader. Oh, actually, on this moment, actually, ST1 is highly similar to CorelDRAW 7 version. Of course, it's not a complete copy of CorelDRAW, but now application is really useful for day-by-day usage. For example, we have used it for real printing our software. On the station board, you can see the stickers. It's not office printing, it's a real screen printing job using 4 Pantone color. And the drawing for this printing was prepared in ST1. And some words about our plans. Next version we are planning to dedicate for application for localization. So if you wish to join into our project to translate our ST1 interface on your native language, so you are welcome. Also, in our plans is improvement of internal rendering, and after that we can port our application on Windows platform and maybe on MacOS platform. But MacOS platform is not our primary goal. That's all. Thank you for your attention. Do you have any questions?
I was wondering if you could talk about the use of ST1 with cutting plotters. That's something I heard about.
Concerning cutting plotters, we have prepared, as for ST1 and Unicon Virtual, but it exporter and importer. So for Unicon Virtual, this importer and exporter will be accessible on next version, which is scheduled on the end of May, before the final part of Trophies du Libre contest. And for ST1, it will be accessible on next version. Also, this importer can be used for Inkscape, because Inkscape used Unicon Virtual. For example, we already used this feature on these stickers. As you can see, it contains plotter cutting. But we don't include in current release because this feature requires additional improvements. Any question?
So for the spot colors, do you produce separations yourself, or do you rely on GoScript or another rip to do that for you?
Wow. Excuse me.
So for spot colors, do you produce separations within the application, or do you rely just make a PDF
key. Concerning separation, for example, for this printing job, is used handle separation because it's a screen printed. But for offset printing, that is four color printing, smart printing, you can print in your drawing into PDF, and after that go directly to printing bureau and print prepress films. We doesn't plan to create additional separation of fields because it's not needed. Usually this separation is created by hardware, and software separation is not useful. So our primary goal is to create correct PDF document with SMIC, spot colors, and registration colors. For example, we also support registration color. So all marks on the films will be black if you use this color. Not only for SMIC colors, and also for spot films.
How is STA1 different or similar to Inkscape?
It's a usual question because often people say why you don't work together on one application and why you create two different vector editors. Out of your features is highly similar. The reason why we create our own application is because Inkscape is an SVG editor. Our tool is not SVG editor. We have own format, and our primary goal is prepress industry, not not screen graphics. So we. Our development has a goal to provide minimal instruments, minimal set of instruments for prepress workers, but not for decisioners. Altas, Inkscape, and ST1 similar application. They have different goals.
Any more questions? Okay. Thank you.
Thank you for your attention.